Okay, online golf fans. So I'm at Sun River Resort playing around with the new gizmo from Tour Striker, the Tour Striker Educator. And some of you have inquired about it, and I appreciate that. It'll be available soon. It's just taking a little bit longer to get to market than anticipated. But I've just put a couple driver swings on for you. I mean, there's a variety of things you can do with this. This is just one of the positions you can put it in. You know, your typical slicer is going to over-rotate the club face, and you can see it's this white gizmo that is sticking up between my forearms here, and you can see it on the downline view right there between my body and forearms. So in the backswing, you know, you're going to have most of your over-rotated cuppers. Right now, that indicator is against the inside of my left forearm. It's because of my backswing. My left wrist is going from a bent condition to somewhat of a flat condition. I'm establishing my impact alignments on my way back. So that indicator is rubbing against the inside of my left forearm, and then in the hinge, you can see that there's a little gap in here now between the bulbous end of the educator and my forearm. And what's going on here? And this is some of your better players aren't going to need this drill, but you can kind of see how now the flattening of my left wrist has got this in a position to where it can now present itself to the outside of my left forearm on the way down. So for you slicers, if you can learn this feel and you can learn how to let this indicator on the Tour Striker Educator go from underneath to the outside of your left forearm on the way down, you're going to do a lot of good things in your downswing. And a lot of good things with that club face and swing path. So you see on the way down, there's actually a greater distance between the tip of the educator and my left forearm. Because the club's kind of cocking itself a little bit more, there's a lot of weight at the end of this stick right here. And as a result, it really influences the angle between my left arm and golf club. So my rotation is really helping to set my hands a little deeper on the downswing. And as a result of that, you can see how there's just a little bit bigger gap. Whoops, wrong tool here. Let's clear that off and use the right one. There's a little bit bigger gap now with the tip of the educator in my left arm. So what's going on here though, in the downswing, as I'm approaching the ball, you can see how the tool is now on the outside of my left forearm. When it started, is on the inside. So here's this little magic move. That's really going to benefit some of you out there, especially you slicers, to teach you how to have a leveraged impact condition on up into a finish. So here it looks down the line as this tool works its way from under my forearm to outside and over my forearm. And then as the club uncocks and rolls into impact, that was probably a bit of a toe strike. Face popped open a bit and up into a finish. So anyway, just a simple little tool that'll be on the market soon to help you understand what the hands do. You know, nobody likes to talk about hands in the golf swing, but they do have a role. They have to be educated. Once they're educated, then you can utilize them and actually forget about them. But there is certain things the hands have to understand, they have to do, you have to train in, and then you can forget about. But until you do that, you're always going to struggle. So anyway, this is just one of the little drills that you can do, the under-over drill, as my wife Stacy likes to call it, to help you strike the golf ball a little bit better. Thanks for watching.